Good afternoon, we're live from Radical Whiskey Company Studios. Woohoo!
Whoa, we have set up a beautiful battle. The Battle of the Bourbons.
We're here next Sunday, is it Sunday?
Yes, Sunday, July 4th.
So I thought it's going to be American Independence Day, and we thought what better way to celebrate than to dig out a nice bourbon for American whiskey.
Two or four.
Or two or three from our vaults. Ready to enjoy on Independence Day.
That's
July 4th. It's going to be 245 years since America declared independence.
I remember it fondly.
Oh, do you? See? Americans like to celebrate with barbecues, bonfires, fireworks.
You know what? I'm
carnivals.
Always jealous of that part of the culture.
Yeah.
Is that they have these amazing smoked meats and smoke houses and have competitions, which I watch. They have on Netflix a couple of shows.
Yeah.
And they have these huge hunks of beef.
Indeed.
And they slow smoke them. And it's just amazing.
Yeah.
So
did there
you
we
guys
go.
Know from the 40, I think it's 40 founding fathers around that, about a quarter of them were actually from Wales.
Really?
Ooh,
I did not know that.
There we go.
I resident Welsh.
More
but a lot of them were, I don't know about the founding fathers, but definitely a lot of Americans at that point were a lot of the Scotsmen.
And they were also quite religious type as well.
Yes, indeed. But then it amazes me that then what they generally drink are rye and other types of
So bourbon is very popular, obviously, in America.
Indeed.
But
it's not
you know, Scotch is also really popular in America.
Indeed,
I feel like Scotch is more popular in America, maybe.
Potentially.
But.
Yeah, well, there we go. Anyway, so if I'm looking for something to enjoy on Independence Day at my barbecue.
Vic's mentioning something about bourbon, I'm sorry.
No, Victor, we don't want to know. You stick to your Scotch malt.
Right, so I thought I would kick it off with... I think it's probably the most popular bourbon in the UK. They sell this by like megatons load.
Indeed.
You know,
okay.
It comes in at great prices. I think 28
pounds.
Okay,
so definitely
and
an easy.
Don't think I'm odd, but smell that and tell me what you think. Sweets and beautiful rye. It smells great, right? No. Give it another smell. Do you have COVID?
It's like a bottle.
What?
It feels like a wind-up.
No, no.
I don't know where he's getting that
from. Smell the label. Smell the label. It smells great. It smells... I get it when I open the boxes of bourbon. Okay.
Right,
whatever.
Is
we'll move on
you?
From that one.
Perhaps. Anyway, yeah.
Either way, what I thought was very cool. It's meant to be quite a well-balanced, not one of those ferocious bourbons.
Yeah.
And what I thought was quite cool is that they still hand-dip each individual bottle. So everything is slightly different. And they used, I think it was the original, so they revamped this in the 50s.
Yeah.
And they used still the same label cutter.
Oh, interesting.
Okay. Yeah.
And it's like a parchment. I mean, that's
it's
like a smelling different to.
Yeah, no, also it smells a lot like, you know, a little bit sweetie and I don't know. Don't laugh at me, but.
Like maybe smell labels.
No, it smells great.
Moving swiftly onwards. Okay, so we've got
for
the
28 quid.
Okay.
I don't think you can get better value
okay.
in this category.
Fair. All right, Jackson, what's your suggestion?
I'm going to have to disagree on that.
Okay,
all
right.
Because I think.
Yeah.
Going in that lower end great value, Evan Williams now,
right.
as I said. It was going to come back up. Evan Williams hails from Pembrokeshire in Wales.
Really?
No wonder
it's on your list.
The 1780s, 1790s, he headed over.
Yeah.
Evan Williams was actually credited as the first ever licensed distillery.
Oh, really?
In
Kentucky,
yeah.
Oh, I see. Oh, okay, fine. So it's a Kentucky,
so,
but is it a
bourbon?
Yes,
bourbon, it is a bourbon.
So,
a straight bourbon.
Minimum percent.
Corn whiskey of 51%.
Yeah.
100% proof. That's this whole 100% proof. It's all about being bottled in bond.
Yeah.
So where we have the 3 years for Scotch, the bottled in bond is 4 years in a federal warehouse. And it's, as we know, obviously about casks, it's all in the charred new casks.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you see like charcoal filters.
And that feeds,
kind of
and those casks feed a lot to the Scotch
they
industry. Because
yes.
they have
yeah.
to make a new one. The Scotch generally have.
And I think it's about 50%.
Well, 100% proof is ABV. Yes, you do exactly double it to make ABV. Okay, and retail's at?
33, 34, something.
Okay, all right. Sweet.
A little bit spicy, I believe. But it's kind of like spicy on the palate, but kind of sweet on the nose, that typical bourbon kind of caramel.
Okay.
Vanilla, honey, kind of like honey and all that stuff. So.
All right. Cheers.
Right. So next, I've got four, two Jackson's, three. So I may just do two quickly. This one is a little bit of a curveball, but it's not a bourbon. It's an American whiskey.
Okay.
This is the Westland brand, and they have very popular stuff. They have, you know, the sherry, the American oak, and the peated.
And is it malt? Is it barley?
It's got a few different things in there, but I think it is malt.
Okay.
Their claim to fame is that they have five different malts that go into it.
Yeah.
And only one of those.
Single malt. Okay.
Yeah. And only one of those is actually peated. So three quarters or whatever the actual figure is, more than half of the actual malt that goes in there, the liquid, is not actually peated. So they've done it in a way so it's not going to be a huge hit like your Lafroy's and your Ardbeg.
Yeah.
But that's going to just be a nice, pleasant.
So it's more
back
like
of the
Speyside peated. So
it's actually Highland. It's a Highland peat. So you've got the more smoky bonfire rather than the medicinal.
I suspect that for many a Scotch drinker, that
it's not going to hit the mark. It's more acclimatized for an American or less
intense
smoky fan.
But I'm saying for somebody that's maybe not a bourbon fan, but wants something American on
for July 4th. Yeah, that's why
Okay.
So I actually was I was at the release when they brought it into the UK. So that was also very cool.
Cool. All
and that comes in at about 66
£60. So not a cheap dram, but
not cheap
without an age statement, but
meant to be fun.
Okay.
Meant to taste good.
All right. And you tried it then?
I've tried that one. Okay. I've tried the whole full range and I was really impressed.
Okay.
Then you've got two. I'm gonna do one and then we'll do the other. From the Willett brands. So here is the Rowan Creek.
Yeah.
So this is a bourbon. It's named after the river that runs through the distillery.
Yeah.
It's meant to be a step up than your average bourbon.
Okay.
You know, it's meant to have that premium aspect to it. It's got quite a large amount of raisin and caramel. So it is meant to be quite flavorful.
Are people drinking that or collecting it?
So that one's a drinker.
Okay, and how much is that one?
That one I think is 56.
Okay.
$56.99.
Okay, that's the Rowan's Creek Kentucky Bourbon. Also, about you.
And that's from Willett.
Yep.
So now, also from Heaven Hills.
Yeah.
So what I didn't say on the Evan Williams was that they all come from the Heaven Hills Distillery.
Ah, okay,
and
fine.
Heaven Hills is one of the largest, if not the largest, producer. I think it's the largest family-owned independent.
Yeah, and you've got some star names in there.
Yeah,
like
you've got
Elijah Craig.
Massive collection.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, some of the household names come from this.
Yeah.
But the distillery is in Kentucky.
Yeah.
But the bottling is in Bardstown.
Ah, okay.
So it's kind of separated. And this is not a bourbon, even though distilled out of the Heaven Hill, but it's distilled in the traditional Pennsylvanian straight rye style.
Okay.
So straight rye is 51% minimum rye whiskey, whereas bourbon is corn.
The opposite with corn.
Mm.
Yeah.
This
also, they spelled it whiskey without an E, which is really
interesting.
Because now they don't, now it's not American whiskey.
Yeah. Mm. But again, similarly, 100% proof. So they've gone under the same bottled and bonds scheme.
Yeah.
So it's 4 years old.
Yeah.
So
it's probably quite spicy as well.
It's 51%. Yeah, even more spicy. It's actually got 65% rye content.
Wow. So that probably gives you quite a lot.
23, 22.
Probably gives you
also,
quite a lot.
Look at the colour of that. It's almost like wine.
Mm. It looks really cool. It's very popular.
Okay.
Interestingly, with Heaven Hill, they actually had a massive fire in 1996.
Yeah.
90,000 barrels went ablaze. So they actually had to lean on some of their kind of Kentucky neighbors to help with their production for a few years just to keep going.
Cool.
But yeah, definitely an interesting one. If you're into that kind of spicy, really intense, kind of that's
bourbon.
Really, then that's
all over your mouth.
And I guess that's on that.
Thank you.
So this one, so as you were talking about the collectible cult like, for Willett, it's the actual Willett brand. And this one is the family estate. So they call that that. It's the only bottle produced with their coat of arms.
Yeah.
And it's produced and chosen by the family. So it's hand chosen. It bottled at cask strength. This one's the four-year-old. They actually just started this in 2010. So it's relatively young. The first one they brought out was the two-year-old, and then this one was the next version, which is the four-year-old. It really, really popular, and you don't even need to talk about it because Willett, you've just got those fans. You just snaps up everything.
Price on that?
Price on that one is £83.
Oh, okay.
So it's a little bit more premium.
You're going to say a lot more than that, but okay.
So the older age Willetts, the distillery exclusives, that sort of stuff goes for a couple of £100, and those get. And you've got the younger age Willetts, which are the more reasonably priced ones.
Yeah. Okay. All right. Thank you.
Well, speaking of higher aged premium,
goes
along this Parker's.
Yeah.
So this is an 8-year-old.
Okay.
And this is a whole collection. Basically, Parker's Heritage Collection. It's all kind of after their late master distiller Parker Beam, and it's their real kind of I guess sentimental collection to honor his memory. You know, they go for excellence all across the board. So this is a makeup of 75 different barrels that were all charred for a minute and a half. Standard for the brand and across is 40 seconds, which is level 4.
Right.
So this is intense charring.
Okay.
Right. So it's probably
a heavy char barrel. So is that similar to it's not peat, is it?
No.
It's more caramel, vanilla,
spices.
Right. So is it really?
It makes
spices.
The cask.
Right.
Yeah, because you get that kind of like as it cooks the wood, and it's just kind of gives those intense notes.
The tannins that are in the wood. Yeah, well, we were sniffing labels, I'm not shocked.
And a lot of interaction with the wood at that level as well. So
eight years.
Higher proof, so it's 52.5%.
Okay.
And also not a bourbon again, and again another rye whiskey.
Yes.
And this time spelt with an E. Okay, that's a bit of consistency. Well, there we go. All right. So,
that is
price.
£285.
Ah, okay.
So that's much more premium.
Okay.
But we did do
delicious.
If you're thinking about it, if we're making a barbecue,
indeed,
I'm all in. I'll bring this.
I'm
one.
Happy to host.
I'll bring this one.
I'll host the barbecue. You just bring the meat.
But we did make a special code.
Yes, we did.
A special discount code until July 4th. So to get all your bourbons in, any American whiskey or bourbon, we're giving off, 7%? Just put in USA.
Oh, is that it?
USA. I could be a football player.
Well, there we go. Just don't do it anymore.
No, not near the whiskey.
So there we go. Enter code USA at the checkout for a special discount. There we go. Happy July 4th, guys.
Enjoy.
See ya. Thanks. Bye.
You're telling me.